Hi students, welcome to the video lecture 3 on the topic fluid kinematics. So in the today's class we will study velocity and acceleration. So let v be the resultant velocity at any point in a fluid flow. Let u, v and w are the velocity components in the x, y and z directions. So these velocity components u, v and w are the functions of space coordinates as well as time. So mathematically how these velocity components are written, where u, it is a function, that is f1, function of x, y, z and t, where v is the velocity component, where v is the velocity component in the y direction, it is f2 is a function of x, y, z and t, where w, it is the function of x, y, z and t. So this capital V is the resultant velocity. So how we'll calculate this resultant velocity? This capital V is equals to this, we have written it in the vector form, u into I plus v into j plus w into k. So this will be equals to root of u square plus v square plus w square. So if we want to calculate the resultant velocity, we are going to use this formula. So now let us study acceleration. So let ax, ay and az are the total accelerations in the x, y and z directions respectively. So then by the chain rule of differentiation, so how we'll write this ax, that is acceleration in the x direction. So how acceleration is given? Acceleration is defined as the rate of change of velocity with respect to change in timing. The change of velocity divided by time taken is nothing but the acceleration. So this is the acceleration which is given in the x direction. So in the x direction, where u is the velocity component in the x direction. So by chain rule of differentiation, how we'll write this equation? Dou u by dou x into dx by dt plus dou u by dou y into dy by dt plus dou u by dou z into dz by dt plus dou u by dou t. So next, the same equation I have written here, acceleration ax, that is du by dt is given by this equation. Now this dx by dt is equals to u, that is velocity. So how velocity is given? Displacement divided by time. So dx is displacement, dt is divided by time taken. So displacement divided by time is nothing but velocity. So this velocity u is the component in the x direction. For that purpose, here dx by dt is indicated by u, where dy by dt is indicated by v, because v is the velocity component in the y direction, where w is the velocity component in the z direction. For that purpose, we have written dz by dt is equals to w here. So now these u, v and w values I will substitute in this above equation. So it is ax, dou u upon dou x, du by dt is equals to dou u upon dou x, remains equation remains as it is, whereas ds by dt is replaced by u, plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. So this dz by dt is replaced by w here, dy by dt is replaced by v here, plus dou u upon dou t. Now how we have written the equation acceleration ax in the x direction, so similarly we'll write the equation for acceleration in the y direction. So how acceleration is given in the y direction? Dv by dt. So this equation will remain same, u, but these equations are going to change here, that is dou v by dou x plus v into dy by dt. This equation will remain same as it is, v into dou v upon dou y plus w into dou v upon dou z, because we are writing the expression that is acceleration in the y direction plus dou v by dou t. So similarly, we'll write the expression for z direction, where it is given by dw upon dt. So by the chain rule of differentiation, we are going to write the same equations here. But in the chain rule of differentiation, how we'll get here? Az is equal to dw upon dt, that will be equal to dou w upon dou x into dx by dt. So dx by dt is replaced by u here, same equations. U into dou w upon dou x plus v into dou w upon dou y plus w into dou w upon dou z plus dou w upon dou t. So these are the equations how we will write the accelerations. Ax in the x direction, ay in the y direction, acceleration in the z direction. So now in the previous same equation, if the flow is a steady flow, then this dou v upon dou t is equals to 0. So when this dou v upon dou t is equals to 0, where v is the resultant velocity, so then definitely where v resultant velocity is given by root of u square plus v square plus w square. So then definitely dou u upon dou t becomes 0 if the flow is steady flow. Dou v upon dou t becomes 0. Dou w upon dou t also becomes 0 because the flow is steady flow. That means there is no change in velocity with respect to time. Hence acceleration in the x, y and z direction becomes same previous equations. Ax is equals to du by dt, same equations I have written here. U into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z plus here dou u upon dou t equation was there, but as the flow is steady flow, this equation becomes 0. So there my this is my final equation. Similarly, Ay, dv by dt is equal to u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y plus w into dou v upon dou z, where dou v upon dou t is equal to 0. This equation becomes 0 here. So similarly, we have written the equations for z directions here. Now, total resultant acceleration. How we'll write it in the acceleration form, that is capital A is the resultant acceleration or total acceleration. Axi plus Ay into J plus Az into K. This also we have written it in the vector form. Then if we want to calculate total velocity A, that will be equals to root of square root of Ax square plus Ay square plus Az square. So this is how to calculate the resultant acceleration or total acceleration. So now we'll study what do you mean by local acceleration and what do you mean by convective acceleration. This local acceleration is defined as the rate of increase of velocity with respect to time at a given point in a flow field. So in the previous expressions, what we have derived, see dou u by dou t, dou v by dou t, dou w upon dou t is known as local acceleration. That means local acceleration is defined as the rate of increase of velocity with respect to time. So this is the rate of increase of velocity with respect to time. For that purpose, these equations are known as local accelerations. Now convective acceleration, it is defined as the rate of change of velocity due to change of position of the fluid particles in a fluid flow. Or we can define this convective acceleration defined as the rate of change of velocity with respect to space. Due to the change of position of the fluid particles in a fluid flow. So the expressions other than these expressions in the previous equations what we have derived, it is known as convective acceleration. See here, the previous equations only I have written here. So this dou u by dou t, dou v by dou t, dou w upon dt, these expressions, equations are known as, these equations indicates the local acceleration. Because local acceleration is defined as rate of increase of velocity with respect to time. See here. And the equations other than these equations, these all indicates the convective acceleration. These all indicates the convective acceleration. This is the convective acceleration in the x direction. That is u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. This is the convective acceleration in the x direction. So this is the convective acceleration in the y direction. So this is the convective acceleration in the z direction.